often when we drive the boat, you know, we can drive it 5 minutes and it's jumping around and everything, and then every once in a while, bad slap. And, you know, what happened? Boats, vehicles. Vehicles are fun. Boats are fun. The Numerat, our boat, it's I think it's a really the first purpose-built boat, built just to study slamming. When you design a boat, there's a lot of loads that you need to apply to your, you know, imaginary boat or your finite element model or whatever you have. And slamming are the highest ones. Those are the main loads. And the slamming is kind of belly flopping into the waves. Very, very high intensity loads. Very short duration also. And since those are the most important loads for designing the boat, we should know them very accurately. And we don't. The design codes today, you design for a load and it's static. It's just applied and it sits there. Whereas we know in reality, the loads are very, very dynamic and they're very non-uniform. They're not the same. So why do we design for static loads? Because we don't know how to design in a better way right now. And that's one of the things we try to work out. Students were, except for the initial, you know, writing the specification and doing the design of the boat, except for that, that they've been involved in really every phase of the boat. If you're gonna build something, a real engineering part, you're not gonna do it right the first time you try it. It's you're gonna have to try and make your mistakes, and it's from the mistakes you learn. You know, if you're gonna make meatballs, is all you need to do read a recipe and they're gonna make, you know, great meatballs? No, it's unless you build something real, you have no idea what you're doing or what you're gonna need to do to be able to make a real product. Some of our students are working at, you know, the top companies in the world right now. We have two people working on a private manned spaceship right now, Scale Composites down in the Mojave Desert. And you know, they would never be there today if they hadn't done the work they did here at Lehigh. You know, as long as people want to travel, there's always going to be new vehicles, faster, lighter, more efficient. You know, looking at crystal ball, it's going to be a very, very different future from what it is today.